when the future becomes present, you enjoy it as is. That's the wisest way. And that's what we call wisdom. If you don't know it, you're ignorant. Okay? So ignorant is you don't know, you don't accept. You don't accept things as is. If you know how to accept things as is, you're not ignorant. Right? Agree?
It's all about acceptance. It's all about acceptance.
It's all about acceptance. That's all. You're not sad, you're not overjoyed, you always enjoy as you are now. Okay, as you are now. Add anything on top of it, you're wrong. Subtract anything on top from that, you're wrong. Okay? And what you learn here, what I'm trying to tell you, to teach you, is not to accumulate all your knowledge. Not accumulate. Just teach you how to eliminate the unnecessary thought. Like you have a piece of rock, which inside a piece of rock there's a diamond. If you want to get on the diamond, what you have to do? Well, you have to cut, chisel, whatever you do, remove all impurity, or remove everything that is not diamond. So you're learning to remove things out of your mind. You're not learning to touch it on what you know. Remember that. You're not learning anything more. You are learning less. Okay? You're learning to eliminate the unnecessary knowledge. Okay? Unnecessary knowledge. And as I told you, when the Buddha was born with this, and as soon as he was born with that, people around him, like a parent, sibling, teacher, they tried to give him the thing on top of it. Right? They go into the forest and learn, and he attain a certain level of spiritual, but he cannot answer this question because the more he learns, the more he puts on his mind. Okay? So, after learning for 11 years, he cannot understand, or he cannot remove his ignorance. He cannot understand why he was. He started to fight differently. He said, if something from outside cannot help me, is there anything from inside could help? Then he started an adventure of going inside. But unfortunately, he was barred, blocked by all of his knowledge. So what he has to do? He has to let these things go, right? Whatever he learned, he has to let it go. He started to let go everything here, and he learned every day, he let each one of them go. Okay, and to the last day, he was back to what he was. okay, then he can enlighten, he became Buddha. So he said, oh, strange. What I have learned does not help me. And what I never learned helped me to be Buddha. Okay? Help me to be Buddha. Because Buddhahood is not what you learn. Buddhahood is something you already have. What we learn from outside, we think it's real. What you learn from Larry, you say, oh, he's a good master. He's a, you know, he's good. He teaches me a good thing. No. You understand it? And then throw it away. And drop it. Okay? I don't need you to take note. Just listen. You understand it? Okay? Then you try to work with that, what you understand. If it doesn't work, then come back, we'll discuss again. Until you master it without making any note. Okay? We are attached on everything. Because everything here, the fan, table, whatever, we attach to them. Okay, we attach to our degree. We attach to our what we have learned in school. We dare not let them go. Okay, and that's what the most advanced we can get is what we have been taught. You cannot get out of what you have been taught. Right? You just cannot. Okay. This is the universe. What you have been taught or what your knowledge is like this. You're walking in this black dot only. You cannot get out here. What out here, you never know. Because you are limited and you agree to be limited on what you have been taught in this black dot. Nobody can teach you out here because nobody knows. Only you can teach you something out here. If you can forget what you have been taught. Okay? And what you have been taught is wrong. Doesn't matter what. Doesn't matter what. What you have been taught is wrong. For example, I show you this pencil or this pen, ask you what color it is. What you say? Red. How do you know? Because you are taught this is a red color.